Hi YouTube, how you doing? Haven't been up to much lately, got nothing to paint, so I thought I'd just do a little video on brushes, just to put something up. I don't know how well these are going to come out, but there's three brushes here. These, if I can get them for focus. Yeah, these are Winsor Newton Series 7 Pure Kolinsky brushes. I'm sure most of you have heard of them. Brilliant brushes. I've had these about a year, and as you can see, there's no stray hairs, no tip curl, nothing. Absolutely spotless. I mean, I do look after these. I use brush soap and I scrape any paint off the ferrules and really look after them. But absolutely love these brushes. It's absolutely amazing. Definitely worth getting. But the one drawback with these brushes is, I think I've got a triple zero, double zero, and a zero there. You'll pay about 10 quid for the zero. Probably 8 for the other one, 6 or 7 for the smallest one. So very expensive brushes, but you look after them, they're great brushes. But I've got a solution to that. If I show you these ones, these are the same. These are Kolinsky's brushes. That's a 3, a 1 and a 000 there. But these are made by, not Winsor Newton, these are Rosemary & Co ones, and these ones equally as good as those. As you can see, excellent tips, no stray brushes, lovely brushes. And these will cost you, I think for the smallest ones about £3, for the biggest ones about £4.50, so probably about half the price of those. Same sort of equal price to what you'd pay for Games Workshop or an Army Painter brush. And as you can see, fantastic points. Lovely and clean. There's no staining in the hairs. Like I say, I look after them. But definitely worth checking out next time you want a brush, because for the same price as you pay for hobby brushes, to get these is well worth it. You look after them, they'll last you ages. Like I say, some of these, most of these I've had a year, and they look almost brand new. So, excellent brushes to work with. They've all got lovely tips. Excellent. So if I show you them all together, you probably wouldn't even notice the difference between them. So definitely worth checking these Rosemary & Co out. I don't think I'll ever buy Winsor & Newton again, just for the price of them. They're so expensive, but these ones are well affordable. Rosemary & Co. I'll just show you the catalogue here if you want to have a look. But this is the company. I'm going to get a load of made brushes. But it's not just the Kolinskys. I mean, I know some people have used Kolinskys and don't get on with them and prefer synthetics or sable or whatever, but they do brushes in, well, basically it's about 11 or 12 just different sort of mediums they use to make their brushes. But they're all really well priced, cheaper than anything you're going to get in the shops, but top quality. It's an online only company, but, so you've got red sable, pure red sable, some really, as you can see, some of these shapes and style of some of these brushes. This is the Kolinsky ones. So look at the 10-0 there, price £3.40. Size 0, £3.65. Size 2, £4.30. Very, very reasonable prices. You've got rigger brushes there for pinstriping and stuff, nothing that we'd probably use. But, wouldn't want to buy a size 24 though, £450. Thank you. Anyway, definitely worth checking out next time you want a brush. Very cheap postage and packing as well, only £1 to get them first class delivered. Great prices. Speedy delivery as well, they're usually here within a couple of days. I thought these were quite interesting, these ones up the top here, these Pure Kolinsky Coma. I just thought that 1/8 inch one there might be quite handy if you ever want to do like a wood grain. It's, they're sort of like, as you can see there, sort of like a series of points. It might be handy. I might get one of those 1/8 inch little ones one day and try it out, just to see. It might be handy for some sort of techniques for hair and fur and stuff, wood grain. As you can see, there's loads, but there's red sable brushes, squirrel hair. You've got a lot of the synthetic ones, and they're really cheap as well, down to about a couple of quid each. All handmade. Definitely worth checking out. badger, is that badger? I think that might be badger hair, those. Probably not no good for the sort of stuff we do. But I think this cat, you can get request a catalogue for free if you're interested on the website. There's all sorts in there. So I just thought I'd show you that, just put something up for now. So I'm off the weekend to the war game show, so I'll spend a bit of money and maybe I'll have some stuff I want to paint. So, oh look, they've got these ones. These are, well, no good for us. And these little ones, like travelling brushes, where they come apart and store inside themselves, inside the handle. Don't really see they're much use to a miniature painter. I don't think you've got to be out and about and you suddenly get the urge to paint a miniature. You can just whip a brush out of your pocket. Well, got the iPad over. Okay guys, well, after that little catastrophe, I'll say goodbye. Take care all. Bye bye.